Hey, welcome back. This is Shaw. I sometimes receive pushback or hate if I pronounce Pakistan as Pakistan instead of Pakistan. And I found a thread on the Pakistani subreddit that discussed this. So it made me want to share it with you guys. Let's take a look. What is the opinion on those Pakistani Americans who tell people that they are from Pakistan? It really irritates me when I hear other Pakistani Americans tell the Godas that they are from Pakistan. I never mispronounce the word this way. Just what are they trying to achieve? So I started thinking about that, and I'm one of those people who pronounce it Pakistan. The post specifically mentions Goras, and a Gora means that just means white people. Literally just means like lighter white. And when I'm talking to other Americans, I say Pakistan instead of Pakistan because I think it sounds weird if I'm saying the rest of the language and the sentence in what is an American accent, and then suddenly I just chime in with Pakistan, like somehow I'm gonna lose my Pakistani, cultural background identity card if I say Pakistan. And it's just funny that somebody would get bent out of shape over this. I always thought it was weird when people would do that. I don't know if you guys remember, there used to be this show on Food Network called Everyday Italian. And the host of the show, Giada De Laurentiis, I used to watch Food Network back when I was like 12. And every time a certain like Italian ingredient would come around, she would pronounce it like super properly, even though the rest of her speech was just as American as anybody else.
So add a little bit of fat or moisture. Olive oil, butter, mozzarella, anything softer, cheese-wise.
See how that's weird? It's just weird. She says butter, olive oil. She could just be like mozzarella, but instead she's like mozzarella. And to me, it's just something that kind of distracts you from what you're watching in a way. It feels a little forced. The example I like to use is Paris. I was born in Paris, France. Now, when someone asks me where I was born, especially if I'm talking to an American or I'm in the US or even a lot of other people, I say I was born in Paris. I do not say, yeah, my parents were in France and I was born in Paris or France. It just sounds weird. Now, if I was talking French, I know a little bit of French, but if I was and I was speaking with another person who's also French, then I would say Paris. But other than that, it's completely fine to say Paris because that's how people pronounce Paris here. That is the American pronunciation of Paris. Now let's look at the French pronunciation of Paris.
Know that the S at Paris in French is silent, as is often the case with the last letter of a word in French. So the French would say Paris, Paris, Paris.
So that's how you say Paris in its most organic form, if you're French, and if you're French, it makes sense. If a Pakistani came over here to visit and he didn't grow up here or whatever, he would say Pakistan. My father says Pakistan. But if they say America, they're going to say Amrika. But that's because they're from Pakistan and it just makes sense. But if it's me they're talking to, I'm not going to be like, hey, whoa, whoa, it's America. Because I know what they're saying. But some other Americans who don't have a Pakistani background, they might get a little confused and say, I'm sorry, I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, America. Oh, okay. I just didn't recognize it when you said it like that. And it essentially goes down to code switching. Code switching is essentially when you grow up here in the US or somewhere else, and you kind of have a couple different ways of carrying yourself or presenting yourself. And if I'm talking to my dad, I'll say Pakistan. If I'm talking to someone at the child support agency where I used to work, I'd say, oh, yeah, my parents were born in Pakistan. And I was born in Paris. And it just makes sense. It's so funny because thinking about that, I remember when I first started at child support, there was this coworker I had, and she was, when I pronounce my full name, it's it's the real way to say it is shahrukh, okay? But growing up in school and all that stuff, everyone would pronounce my name Shahrukh. Now at home, it's shahrukh. And what's interesting about that is what triggers the code switch for me is how someone says my name. So I'm used to school version of me and work version of me under shahrukh. So if someone calls me that, I'm already in that mode. If someone calls me shahrukh, then I know, oh, well, it's my family or someone in my tribe or something. It's just different. And then that's the code switch for that. But I remember there was this coworker I had at child support, and she was just like, well, you don't even know how to pronounce your own name. Or she was like upset or offended, you know, because they're like, well, how do you pronounce your name? And I was like, shahrukh is fine. That's, you can call me that. Now I go by Shah. There was this noticeable shift, I think, after we had the handoff transition from George Bush to Obama. And you see this transition in the pronunciation of not only Pakistan, there was the George W. Bush Pakistan.
Contribute to helping the people of Pakistan recover. They are our friends.
Then there was the Obama Pakistan.
Gravely concerned about the situation in Pakistan.
You hear that? Pakistan. So that's 2009. And then just prior to that, you know, it was, so that's, you know, Obama was elected. Prior to that, it was George Bush. And it goes from Pakistan to Pakistan. Now let's listen to Iraq.
My fellow citizens, at this hour, American and coalition forces are in the early stages of military operations to disarm Iraq, to free its people.
And then there was the President Obama, Iraq.
The political system is holding and functioning in Iraq.
It was a very subtle change, you know, from Bush to Obama. And I think it becomes a bigger deal after this, because now it's not just someone saying, you know, a name based off of the region they're from and the dialect and how it's pronounced, how they know it as a people. It's, well, you're progressive if you actually say the name like the way a native person would say it, even though the rest of your language, you know, toolkit doesn't match that. And it starts to take on more of a political turn, just another subtler way of leaning towards one side or the other, instead of, you know, the other person, say Bush prior to him, the implication would be he, you know, is not as understanding because he pronounces the name in a way that might show he's not familiar with the culture, you know. So then you start to get a lot of this people trying to sound as, I guess, authentic as possible, even though they're not from there. To me, it's weird because coming from the, you know, code switching, it's just something you do. And suddenly it's like, if you code switch and then you inject, like, it's if someone asked me where my parents are from and I'm suddenly going to just put Pakistan in there. I don't want to actually merge these two worlds together. Like, there's home, there's work out here in America or school. And it just depends who my audience is, you know, in terms of how I'm going to pronounce the word. And just to see an example of code switching, let me show you what code switching looks like.
Holy Scott Foley, I can't believe we're being so whiskey cavalier about sneaking away from a field trip.
I'm gonna need you to calm down.
Hey, my bad, big dog.
Ain't none, bro. You didn't even scuff the forces.
Shit, I'd have gave myself the fade right quick.
You're stupid, bro. On God, though. I'm trying to get like you.
Nah, I'm trying to get like you. Yo, stay up, fam.
Stay up, bro.
Devon, I've never heard you talk like that before.
How do you talk to black people?
The same way I talk to white people. What?
Are you serious? You don't have one of these?
What?
You don't have a code switch?
So this is the code switch, right? So there's him when he's talking black. Then here's for the liberal white people, super duper black. I didn't even notice that before. And then there's for regular white people. I just think that's such a great explanation of what code switching is. But it is a thing, and I never fault anyone for doing that. I mean, at the end of the day, it's you're from a place, and then you know you're speaking with the majority population, and it just seems weird to me. I mean, almost in that Giada De Laurentiis way, where she's like butter, olive oil, mozzarella.
Olive oil, butter, mozzarella, anything softer, cheese wet.
It just doesn't match. It doesn't fit the right way, and I think it's a little bit too try hard. Going back to the post. He says he's irritated when he hears other Pakistani Americans tell the Goras that they are from Pakistan. So in the sentence, he reveals that he's talking about Pakistani Americans talking to white people, you know, and really what they're just doing is they're code switching. And that's all it is. And I actually left him, or he got zero upvotes because a lot of the community didn't take it well. I left a comment of my own. I responded, I say Pakistan, LOL, because I grew up in the U.S. and I have an American accent. Personally, when people ask me where I was born, I say Paris, pronounced Paris. I think it would be awfully pretentious to say I was born in Paris. People who suddenly change their accent for one word when they pronounce everything else in a specific accent are weird to me. I'll let you native Pakistanis pronounce Pakistan the proper way. It sounds better coming out of you than me anyways. So... anyways, if this is something you're struggling with, I say just let it go. It's okay however anyone decides to pronounce, you know, Pakistan or Pakistan or Paris or Pahi or Iraq or Iraq. And it just, you know, shows you where they come from. And that's how they were, you know, raised to speak. It's okay to have a regional pronunciation of something. We can't all be expected to say things like, you can't go in here and like do like this language overhaul and then be afraid to pronounce someone's, you know, place of birth or even name because you're not sure how it's going to sound, you know. Anyways, hope you enjoyed that. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you on the next one.